Hi everyone, and welcome to another experiment on PlutoSDR, software-defined radio. So as you can recall, SDR means software-defined radio. Right, so this is the Pluto device. So currently connected to it is an antenna on the receiver and a load on the transmitter. So the load, so what's the purpose of the load? Recall from the last video, I mentioned that leaving the transmitter open is a dangerous basically, because anything that's being transmitted in a transmitter will be reflected back to it and it could fry your chip. Okay, so not to worry much on the software defined radio though, because the output power is not that large, but still it's better to be safe than sorry. Okay, so the 50 ohm load here is used such that anything that's transmitted by the transmitter will be absorbed by the load. Okay, it won't be reflected back. So what's the theory behind that? You can just go back to your transmission line theory. Okay, I'll refer you to a video about that. Okay, so that's how it works. So 50 ohms is a standard in most radios. Some use 75, some use 200, some use 100 ohms, some use 150, but the most common is 50 ohms. Okay, so there you go. And I mentioned last time that the add-on Pluto is around 15,000 Philippine pesos or $300. This is already a cheap low-end radio. Like, there are cheaper radios, but this one has transmitting capabilities. Okay, compared to the other cheaper software-defined radio. But the more powerful software-defined radio, the ones that I've used, are upwards of 300,000 Philippine pesos. Okay, some even go up to 1 million, and that's very 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 expensive, right? So in US dollars, that's above $1,500 US dollars, and they're not used for learning. It's impractical, but we can use them for more powerful radio prototypes, right? So for this series of videos, we'll just use Adam Tuto. So this is actually just designed for learning. Now, for this video, we want to use the add-on Pluto as an FM radio receiver, as indicated in the title. However, the FM radio here in the Philippines operates at 88 megahertz to 108 megahertz. Right. The problem with the radio what we have right now is it's marketed for 325 megahertz above. So that means we can't use it to receive FM radio signals, right? From the broadcasts of the stations here in the Philippines. Well, not to worry. According to the wiki of your add-on Pluto, okay, so let me show it. Okay. There we go. So according to the wiki of analog devices, the Pluto SDR can be configured such that it can operate at 70 megahertz above. Okay, so I'll put the link on the description, okay? The description in the video description below. Okay, the chip that's used here for add-on Pluto is for 70 megahertz to 6 gigahertz, but it was limited by software since the hardware of the add-on Pluto is only optimized for 325 megahertz to 3.8 gigahertz. Okay, so we can try to use it as an FM radio operating at 88 megahertz. However, we may not have a satisfactory performance in those frequency bands, but that won't stop us because we just want to learn, right? Okay, so the first thing you need to do once you buy an add-on Pluto unit is that you need to hack it. Okay, and this link right here can be used for hacking the add-on Pluto. Okay, so how do we do that? First things first, you just connect the add-on Pluto to computer. So that's already done here. Sorry. Okay, right here. So it's already connected to computer, blinking lights. Okay. And we have to connect via a secure shell connection, SSH connection. So I use TerraTerm for that. So the host is, well, the IP address of the add-on Pluto, connect via SSH, and you'll get this challenge. It wants a username and a password. Okay, bad security, we don't care. It's local anyway. Right, so the username is root and the passphrase is analog. Okay, and you're now inside the PlutoSDR shell. Okay, so you can change the firmware from here. Right, so from here, you just type in firmware fw_set_environment the attribute name to AD9364. Okay, so the other thing you need to do is, so you just follow this guide actually, but it's somewhere right here. There you go. You set the environment attribute name. Sorry, it should be attribute name. I apologize. Attribute name to compatible, not AD9364. Okay. And you set the attribute value to AD9364. So AD9364 is the firmware used for 70 megahertz to 6 gigahertz for this chip. Okay. So by default, I believe it's AD9363, which operates at 325 megahertz to 3.8 gigahertz. AD9364, 70 megahertz to 6 gigahertz. So we set that, and we have hacked the PlutoSDR. Okay? So after that, just need a reboot. Okay. So, while waiting for the reboot, let's open up the GNURadio companion. Okay, let me just turn off my camera. Okay, there we go. So, the receiver that you see here, the FM receiver, has just some simple blocks. We have the PlutoSDR source, which is the receiver of the PlutoSDR, okay, connected to the configured to the IP address of the SDR already. The LO frequency is set by the variable tuning, which is here under the Qt GUI chooser. Sampling rate is under the fixed variable samp underscore rate, and the RF bandwidth is set to fixed to 500 kilohertz. Okay, the other things are by the default settings of your PlutoSDR source. Tuning here is a chooser GUI. So I set 4 different stations that are broadcasting here in Metro Manila: Wish 107.5, Yes FM, Home Radio, and DWRK, Easy Rock. Okay, and these are the frequencies that are used by these FM radio stations. Okay, so we'll choose which frequency we'll tune to when we turn on the radio. Okay, so the rational resampler will decimate the sampling rate, so it will reduce the sampling rate so that the hardware here, my computer, will be able to handle the amount of data. Okay, the squelch is used such that if the signal from the rational resampler is very small, okay, if it's very small, then the squelch will reject that and will not output anything. Okay, so it's kind of like a threshold, right? So if it has a strong FM signal in its output here, we will be able to hear the output of the FM signal. Okay, FM demodulator block. Okay, so the channel rate is basically the sampling rate divided by the decimation that we have here, so that the sampling or the amount of data that is being inputted to the FM demodulation block is consistent. The audio decimation is set such that we want to reduce the sampling rate of the input to 48 kHz, since 48 kHz is the native sampling rate that is supported by the audio driver of this computer. Deviation is basically the maximum frequency deviation. It's basically a modulation parameter. You can refer back to the FM demodulation and modulation lecture for the definition of this deviation. The audio pass here refers to a filter with a passband cutoff of 16 kHz and a stop band frequency of 20 kHz. Okay, we set the gain to constant, and we now have your FM demodulator block. This multiply constant here will set the volume via software. Okay, so the volume can be reconfigured in the program. Also, the squelch can also be reconfigured in the program. We'll see later how it works. And the audio sync connects to the audio hardware here in this computer. Okay, so let's try to run the flow graph. If you did not configure your radio correctly, you won't be able to run the program. Okay. So we hear noise. There we go. There's some intelligible sound that we hear when we release the volume. Okay, there we go. So I hope you can hear me now, right? So we're connected to Wish 107.5. So let me move around. There we go. We have a clearer signal. I bind my nails and tell the truth. I go from thin to overweight, day to day it fluctuates. So this is the broadcast of Wish 107.5. And as you can see, as I move around, you can see something at the middle of the spectrum. That's the output signal of the broadcast station. Okay. Sorry. Yeah, there we go. Just moving it around for pickup of signal. Okay, let's switch station. Let's try SFM. There we go. This is your SFM radio. It's playing the Tagalog song right now. Okay, let's try to change the position of the radio. Let's see if there's any variation in signal. Yeah, at some point it becomes a little bit noisier. Okay. Let's try third station. It seems like the third station here, as you can see, is not aligned with the center frequency. Very far away. So it could be a problem with the PlutoSDR, or it could be a problem with the transmission of this radio station, right? Okay. And finally, Easy Rock. First one is yes, that's in Manila. Okay, so let's try to change the squelch and the volume. Let's see if it affects the transmission. If we increase the squelch too much, we won't be able to hear any more FM signal at all, because the squelch is also rejecting that FM signal. So, if you have any questions about this experiment or comments, do not hesitate to leave a comment in the comment section below. Oh, wait, sorry. Let me just turn off this. Okay, there we go. Okay. So, again, that concludes our experiment. If you have any questions or comments about this experiment, do not hesitate to leave a comment in the comment section below. I'll gladly try to address your comment. Okay? So, the links that I described here in this video will be posted in the video description. Okay? Thank you for listening. Thank you for tuning in. Pun intended. So, see you next experiment. Bye-bye!